Guys, this is a request. It's about taking your sword, wearing it on your back, okay? What most people don't know is that Koreans used to wear it like this. They used to have the handle towards the back, scabbard up in the front, like this. Now, ninjas also wore it like this, understanding reverse draws and things like that. But today, I want you guys to understand, if this is the scabbard, you would have an attachment towards the top like this for balance, which ensured that this would hang like this, the handle towards the top, not towards the bottom, otherwise it would slip out. So they would wear it like this. Now, this isn't like a rifle where it goes from here to here, but it's towards the top like this, and it has to open like such. The reason is, it's to keep the handle upwards. So, this would be a very traditional way. Would look just like this, okay? This is how the Koreans used to wear it. Not only that, they had many reasons, such as horseback riding and things like that. But the ninja, the kanja, they used to wear it like this. They also had a little tiny knot with a hole. The reason for this knot and hole is they would also attach things to it like a necklace. But when a ninja wore like this and they had to climb, although there's a suba and people think that it's uncomfortable, these intelligent people, they really don't understand any of the concepts. When you wear it like this, this goes over your head like this so it doesn't fall. And this is the way it should be worn. Now, when you wanna draw, this is the way you would draw. You would take the scabbard, pull it up, grab here, and pull down at the same time, giving you this allowance, okay? When you wanted to resheath, you'd bring it back here, bring this up. The sword goes straight up like this, here. Sometimes you would use a rag and wipe the blood off, and then resheath it quietly, and then bring it down like this, and you're good to go. You can run with it, whatnot. Now, other people, they think that because of the suba, it's very uncomfortable towards the back. That is absolutely not true. How do you deal with that? You take the scabbard, you take your obi, put it like this, and it would stick out, and it wouldn't hurt you. By the way, obis had a lot of secret pockets that people don't know about, and I'm sure it's in their pinchos. Anyways, this is how you would wear it. You could do this. Now, when you want to roll with this, it's very difficult to roll like this. But the proper way to roll from here, you would bring it up like this. From here, take the scabbard, bring it here like this. Going across the body, and you can roll, come out here, or pull like this. This is the correct way to wear a ninja toe or shinobi katana on your shoulder, okay?
All of you, God bless you, and we'll see you guys next time. God.